Economic Alliance presents the Gulf Coast Growth Show, your show for the coast with the most growth, with your host, Jason Lee.
All right, we are live. We had a minor hiccup getting started, but we're ready to rock and roll today. And we are here with Mr. Dennis Winkler and on episode 3 of the Gulf Coast Growth Show, your show about the coast with the most growth. So I usually lead that for my co-host Clint Akin. He has a radio. He has a very Dennis Winkler voice.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So he is also built for this. I have kind of a draw, and it doesn't really bode well. But I'm practicing. I'm getting better. And so I'm going to formally introduce Dennis here in a second. But as my guest today, he's going to help us with our sponsors and acknowledging them. So I'm going to turn it over to him real quick. We're going to give a quick acknowledgement to our sponsors. I'm going to highlight some of the events that we have coming up. And then we'll introduce Dennis formally here on episode 3. So, Dennis, if you want to take our sponsorship.
Oh, Jason, I will. First off, thanks and welcome. But, hey, we have some great sponsors. Industrial Safety Training Council, ISTC, the Industrial Safety Training Council, is proud to support this podcast. ISTC, the nation's leading industrial workforce compliance organization, is committed to the safety of our petrochemical plants, pipelines, and their contractors. Drop us a line at hashtag IAmSafety. McDonough Engineering Corporation is a sponsor. McDonough Engineering Corporation is a full-service engineering firm specializing in industrial site design, including tank terminals, truck loading facilities, and manufacturing and distribution facilities. We are proud supporters of the Economic Alliance Houston-Port Region and this podcast. Check out us out at mectx.com. And then Turner, for over 55 years, Turner Industries employees across the Gulf Coast and beyond have answered the country's toughest industrial challenges. They provide one solution for your success with industrial construction, maintenance, turnaround, pipe and module fabrication, equipment, rigging, and specialized transportation, and associated specialty services. Learn more at turner-industries.com.
See, he nailed that. So, and real quick, we have some events coming up. There is the HASC, Houston Area Safety Council, is hosting their crawfish boil this week. You can actually go to the HAC or SC website for details on location and exact timing. Our media partner is Bick. They have their annual crawfish boil, I'm pretty sure.
It is the season for crawfish.
It is the season. So funny story, but I'm not going to go there today. But it is the time of year. And I think we're gonna be enjoying crawfish boils. Bick always has a phenomenal party. It's gonna be at the Sylvan Beach Pavilion. You can go to BickEvents.info for more information. And ACIT, the Association of Chemical Industry in Texas, will be having their spring golf tournament on Thursday, April 11th. So you can go to their website at ACIT.org to register and get more information. And then we do want to acknowledge our producer, Mr. Bruno Santilli. You guys can follow him on LinkedIn. He's producing some phenomenal content. He's helping us put this out and helping produce the show and getting it out, getting it edited for us, and then the great team here at the Economic Alliance for all their support. So with that, Mr. Dennis Winkler with Winkler
Public Relations.
Public Relations. So Dennis has over 15 years in the with his company,
yes.
And I mean I don't know how many years.
It's 40 or more years of doing public relations work for the industry.
Wow.
and associated industries.
Wow, yeah. So it's interesting. I was telling Maricela before the show set came on. I said I don't really get nervous, but then I was like, I'm going to get nervous around Dennis because Dennis is like, he sets the bar, right? Like on what you're supposed to be like in front of a camera and how you're supposed to behave.
You're kind, but I will tell you, anybody who goes on camera, they always get nervous. When you're not nervous, don't go on air.
Yeah. When you're not, don't go on air.
Don't go on the air.
That means there's a problem.
That's right.
Yeah. And if anybody should know, that'd be you. So, with that being said, we've got a few things we want to tackle today. With it being your specialty and where we're at, I'd love to talk a little bit about really just brand and relations. So there's a significant value, I think, that's brought to branding and the relationships that you have in the community. I'm a relationship guy. I believe in
it. I well know that. Right? Yes.
I think you should nourish them. And I'd love to hear and get your take on how you build a brand, what the relationships are like, and the value of it, especially here as part of the Economic Alliance.
Yeah. No, obviously, we are great fans of the Economic Alliance, Houston-Port Region. We have been involved since the very beginning of the reorganization and founding of it as the Economic Alliance, Houston-Port Region. In fact, they were our very first client.
Oh, wow.
We're proud to say that. We helped reorganize and rebrand, and I think they have become one of the most successful organizations today. It is the organization that we refer clients to for networking and building relationships.
That's wonderful.
And you talk about building relationships, we have as our tagline, working relationships, because we understand how important it is to have a good, solid relationship, and it's important to your brand. It's important that people see you at the events where the influential people are,
mm-hmm.
and you know what? They are at the Economic Alliance events.
Great.
So it's a great organization, and it's integral to our clients as far as building their brand and their image.
Wonderful. Now, we live in an area, and we live in a society that's full of, obviously, if you're going to represent a brand in this area, there's a lot of risk inherently, right? Because we work with high volume, high traffic, and high risk environment. The industrial environment is full of potential dangers and yeah. things of that nature. So you almost have to make sure that you're prepared and you have the right team in place to support you. Talk to me a little bit about the value of relationships and allies when you are faced with
yeah.
the challenging circumstances.
Well, you do have risk, and risk are managed, and they're managed very well by this industry. And you know, I like to tell people that when you look at our contractors who are working in the industry, and you look at the employees who are working for the owner companies in the industry, you'll see that their safety performance, as measured by OSHA recordables, or lost time accidents, are far superior, you know, maybe as many as 5 or 10 times better than just the average manufacturing industry.
Oh,
so
wow.
it's a culture here that is developed. It's over the years, and there's an expectation, because we have risk, we're going to manage those risks, and we're going to work and operate safely with minimal impact on our community, with minimal impact on our employees. I'll never forget one of my first plant managers, you know, telling me, he said, you know, this morning I kissed my wife goodbye. She's expecting me to come home today. And that's my expectation for every employee who works for me, that they go home in the same condition that they left. And, you know, that's a culture.
Right.
So, you know, I mean, that's important.
There's some pride that goes
yeah,
into that.
Well, it is. But you also have to fill, and call it the goodwill bank if you want, but you know, you have to have the relationships, because if something does happen, you have to have relationships with people in the community. And, you know, we have incidents from time to time. And, of course, there is one, you know, one recent, I won't speak to, you know, to that incident. But I'll just remind people that when there is a hiccup, there are people in the community who have a relationship, who know the core values of safety and environmental protection, who will stand behind those companies because they know the employees. You know, I may be out at the softball field, you know, with, you know, a daughter's team, and somebody's out there, and, you know, those people all work together and know one another. We bump into one another, you know, at the grocery store, you know, at church.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we are neighbors, and that's why you'll hear industry say frequently, you know, we have to be a good neighbor.
Wow,
and that's
okay.
And that's developing a relationship. It's getting outside the fence line. It's meeting with, you know, the people through. And that's why we promote Economic Alliance, because you're meeting with the people who are leaders in the community, whether it's business leaders, community leaders, or elected leaders. It's important to know those people, because when you do have a hiccup, you want to have some relationships you can count on.
Right.
And then there's the other factor. You know you're going to look at lessons learned. You know you're going to study what happened, and those people are going to help you get through it. You know, it's as you had said earlier, but probably before we came on the air, you would kind of all lift one another up.
Right.
You know, whether it's in prayer or you know, just in thought, we all lift one another up.
That's great. So there's a difference between branding, marketing, and then public relations, right?
Yeah.
And one of the things that I've observed within this organization, which is rather distinct, is that there's a lot of people who have a vested interest in the environment, the culture, the
right.
things that are happening. If I'm a business owner, right, I work in this area, and I have, let's say another area, and I'm really trying to understand the dynamics of what it means to not only get out and represent my brand, but what is a public relationship
yeah.
feel
well,
like?
Well,
help us understand the dynamics of your role and what that means for people that maybe don't understand what that role is.
Yeah, we'll start, Jason, with brand.
Okay.
You know, brand is what you want your company to be.
Right.
Okay. You know, that's what you hope to project. Image is what people think you are. So, yeah, you have something that you want to be, but are you behaving in a way that people perceive you as that? And that's very important. So, you know, you got brand, you have image. Now, public relations, that's tools and techniques to support your brand and your image. You know, how do you get out there and do those things? You know, for us personally, we look at it at relationship building. You know, we think the most important thing for our company is having relationships, knowing who the community leaders are, knowing who the elected leaders are, knowing who the business leaders are, because that's, you know, that's people we're dealing with. And those are companies that come to us. They want us to help them with business development. So we need to know who those individuals are. And I say public relations, that's, you know, marketing, that's the tool to polish the brand that you want and to make sure that you do actually have the image in the community that you're striving to have.
Well, I think you and your family have done a phenomenal job of establishing that. I know every opportunity I've had the chance has just been a wonderful thing, especially meet Kathy and your son and the family. But we'll talk about them later. But,
Kathy and Ross are terrific. Yeah. You know, I'm so proud to be in a family business. It's a wonderful experience to have a chance to work with your wife, or actually work for your wife and work with your son. That's
well played.
She is the owner. I keep reminding myself.
I always think about your calendar because I feel like you're at every major thing at every major time, and I'm like, there's got to be a Dennis Winkler clone. I don't know how he does it, so it's pretty fun to see. So real quick, let's talk a little bit about some of the things that big news, things that are going on within your organization, the organizations that you support. Tell us a little bit about some of the major things that are coming up.
Yeah, well, you know, our business is promoting others. It's promoting our clients. So, yeah, so I'm, you know, the big news, I'll share several with you.
Okay.
First off, we're here in the offices of the Economic Alliance. So, you know, let's talk about the 10th anniversary of the Gulf Coast Industry Forum coming up September 18th and 19th. You know, when you can draw over 1,200 people into a conference about petrochemical industry and the maritime industry, it tells you how much of a brand you have developed in the image that this community, and when I say this community, I'm talking about the Gulf Coast now, has for the Economic Alliance. You mentioned all the people there, and I could mention names because they're family to me.
Right.
You know, they really are, and they're so good, but they're doing a good job. So September 18th and 19th, the 10th anniversary of the Gulf Coast Industry Forum. It's going to be better than ever.
Yeah, it keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger.
It's you know, I guess
pretty soon we're going to have to use one of these giant warehouses to
we're going to
go down to Gulf Stream.
We're going to find one of our communities that's going to build a convention center so we can host this.
No offense, Pasadena. You have a wonderful convention.
Well, no, that's the city I'm talking about.
Yeah,
they're going to improve that facility.
Oh, they are?
Yes, sir.
Oh, wow. Okay.
That's in the plans.
Oh, fantastic.
So, another client we have is Mobil Steel. They're a steel fabrication company, and their big news is they're celebrating 50 years during this current 2019.
Wow.
Yeah, it's, you know, again, 50 years in business, 50 years of helping build and maintain petrochemical facilities and industrial buildings. You know, that's, I mean, they fabricate the steel that goes up in the ground when we're, you know, when we're expanding these industries.
There you go.
So it's great, and there's going to be a number of exciting events. And to that point of what I talked about earlier, building brand, Mobil Steel is a member of the Economic Alliance, and they're going to be using the Economic Alliance by having stories in, you know, their newsletter and sponsoring events, including the Gulf Coast Industry Forum, because they see value, you know, in working with these leaders in industry that they work for, elected officials who, you know, they work for, because they do work in cities as well with industrial facilities, or I should say commercial facilities.
Right.
Yeah. So, and then I'll, you know, just mention, you know, there's a lot of going on right now. It's a Texas legislative session. And I think I've already been up there four or five, maybe six times, you know, now. We had that opportunity to go up there, work with our elected officials on what's important to us. And as you know, I chair the public policy task force here at the Economic Alliance. And it's very important that we engage with our elected leaders, making sure they know what has been successful in us building business in this region and attracting business to this region. And they're great partners. Right. They really are. But again, we, you know, we need to be up there letting them know what's important to us, so they can be supportive of us.
Yeah, and I think you hit the nail on the head. If you're running an organization, right, you have to take a vested interest in everything that impacts your organization. I think a lot of times people put their heads down, or they send somebody out, right,
yeah,
to gather the information, but they're not, you know, in the trenches. The one thing that I love about this community, not just this organization, but the community, is every single person that has their name on the front understands what's happening around them, because you can't help but want to know what's happening around you, because it's a direct impact to your livelihood and the people you care about. You mentioned it, right? We see them at the grocery store. We see them in the community impacting things, and so it's good to see. So,
well, I tell you, it's southeast out of town. What a great area to actually have a business.
Absolutely.
No question.
Thriving. So with that being said, we're going to jump over and just acknowledge our sponsors again. We have the Industrial Safety Council. So we want to thank them. McDonough Engineering Corporation, as well as Turner Industries. And then we also want to take a moment to, again, acknowledge our producer, Mr. Bruno Santilli, for helping us put this show on. So with that, we're going to shift gears a little bit. We talked a lot about what Dennis does. We talked a lot about branding. Love to take just a little bit of time just to talk a little bit about Dennis, right?
I'm not comfortable doing that. But go ahead and go there.
We'll give it a shot. He's always out representing other people, so we get to find out a little bit about him and what makes him tick, and really what's led them to where they're at today. And I guess the first thing that I'd want to know is, Dennis, your success, right? I know you had a pre-existing lifetime working with major organizations. I think Shell.
I'm a retiree of Shell.
Okay.
Was able to retire very young.
Okay.
Say that again. Very young.
Yeah.
And started a business in Shell.
You're still very young.
That's right.
Right.
Shell,
okay.
Shell has done a wonderful job of helping build my skill sets to do what I'm doing today.
Wonderful. And so I'd love to hear about some of the top things that have contributed to your success. And really led you to be a leader in the field. I mean, really large organizations trust you as their PR guy. And so help me understand what's led to your success.
Well, you know, again, I'm going to go back, and for the people listening, it's going to be redundant, but it's relationships. Building
right.
those relationships is a cornerstone value of Winkler Public Relations, as is integrity, and as is expertise. So those are the
three things.
Yeah,
so I had three takeaways.
Yeah, absolutely.
Relationships, integrity. And tell me a little bit about what those things mean.
Yeah.
I mean, we heard relationships.
Yeah, we talked enough about relationships.
Talking about integrity and expertise.
But integrity, in my mind, that's doing the right thing. That's doing what's right when nobody's watching.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just when somebody knows that if they are involved or engaged with you in some way, and whether it's just as friends, you know, or it's a business relationship, that you're a stand-up person, you're going to live by your word, family, faith, you know, those are the key things. So, that's all part of
Fantastic.
Integrity. Yeah.
Right.
Now, I'm going to jump quickly to expertise, because I'd rather get there than talk about some of the soft skills. expertise comes from experience, but
uh-huh.
it also comes, and you well know, it comes from dedication, you know, being somebody who practices, who studies, who researches, continuing to learn.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, I remember when in the early days of working in the Economic Alliance Organization, we kept talking about you have to continually learn. We have jobs that are changing, becoming more technical. We have skill sets that if you grew up in Deer Park or Pasadena 40 years ago, you could walk out and get a job in industry. Today, that job is operating, computer systems, operating,
right.
Technical boards. So everything's changing, and now we're going to be get into virtual reality and
right.
AI and all these things. So you have to be willing to continue to learn to advance your expertise and your skill set.
Right, right, absolutely. Yeah, we're constantly evolving. One of the things that I've observed, if you were to take observation of learning, is your son Ross. You can tell that he's spent a significant amount of time observing. And
yes.
watching his dad out doing what he does, and is then starting to emulate a lot of those same things. Carrying himself in a professional manner,
yeah.
his articulation, things of that nature. So it's always great to see that kind of lineage being passed down in the same type of behaviors.
Yeah.
And I would imagine in your business, because of the type of clients you represent, you constantly have to be learning. I mean, everything's changing. The last thing you can do is step up in front of an organization.
It is.
not know what you're talking about.
They're counting on us being the experts and communicating that message, you know, out to them. So we have to learn, you know, learn our clients' business.
Right.
And, you know, and by definition, public relations is service to the public trust. You know, it's okay. communicating to the public. And, you know, we value the public trust. We protect that through our own expertise, but also through our own ethics. So, you know, so ethics are very high in any public relations organization.
Wonderful. So we always like to find out what our guests are passionate about, maybe organizations, things that they support. Is there anything that you guys are stand behind or that you're out supporting I know for a lot of us, we all have our things that we stick a flag in the ground and we're out behind that championing that organization. Do you guys have anything under your sheet that you're passionate about?
Obviously many, you know, okay. again, family and faith, you know, that leads mm-hmm. us. But social investment is big. And again, that's, you know, that's something I learned through, you know, my work with Shell, how to get back to the community. And when we talk with clients about how to build those relationships and how to build that brand and image, that's one of the important things. You have to get back to the community. It feels good, but your employees also want to do that. You know, employees are fulfilled by mm-hmm. having the opportunity. So if you have a work day where you go out and you serve the community, employees want that.
That's huge.
It builds morale. It also helps attract good, talented people. So, you know, we stress that with our clients, and most of our clients are very heavily involved in the community and have their own programs. So, yeah,
that's wonderful.
We have things we support, but, man, I'd much rather talk about what my clients support.
Well, that's a powerful powerful. That in itself is using your gifts and your skills
yes.
to expand your broad support, because
yeah.
you're then pushing your organizations to go do the right thing. And I think today with
yeah.
our evolving, what inspires and lifts people to go feel like they're part of something bigger
yeah.
is not a company that strokes a check and puts their name on something and
yeah.
calls it a day.
Yeah.
It's help me know that I do something and I'm part of this. And we talked last week about More Than the Move, which is
yes.
organization that was developed by the Gulf Winds company, but they helped put those tools in place. And I just think it's wonderful that more companies are taking bought into that. And then they have guys like you who are behind them saying, hey, we got to do these things.
That's the right thing to do. And then there are other outreach strategies that can be business strategies as well.
Right.
And again, I'll highlight one because it's an economic alliance, you know, core value.
Right.
And that's workforce development.
Love
well, you know, if you step into the workforce development, you put out programs, and you know, people like Turner and McDonough and ISTC, you know, they need employees, so they want to make sure they're working with the community colleges and they're working with the high school career technology education programs. That's an outreach, but at the same time, it's answering a business constraint of how do we get more employees. So they're doing good for the community, but they're also serving their own mission as a company.
Wonderful. Well, Dennis, we're nearing the end of the show. Like I said, I was so thankful to have somebody that I could spend some time and pick up some stuff from, and also just get to know more about, because I always see you out in the front, but never behind the scenes, and it's fun to have that. And with that being said, is there anything, any highlights that you'd like to celebrate or acknowledge and recognize?
I'll acknowledge
yourself,
one.
For your organization.
Yeah, you teed it up a little bit mm-hmm. earlier. As a company, we've been in business and are now celebrating our 15th year. You know, and again, that's Kathy starting the business, me joining her, and now having Ross on board with us for more than 4 years. So, you know, again, it's a family business that's been to all degrees successful. You know, certainly successful beyond my own expectations.
Unbelievable.
So we're, you know, we're happy about that.
Wonderful. And then I always like to think about gratitude. I know we typically start our show with an attitude of gratitude, and I dropped the ball on that one today. So I got to circle back and give mine before I wrap up, but I'd love to hear really what you're grateful for. When you wake up every day and say, today's the day I'm grateful and thankful for.
Well, my success is a gift from our Lord. There's no question about that. I didn't achieve this on my own. I had His help. But I've also had the help of a lot of outstanding mentors. You know, I mentioned working for Shell. I had great mentors at Shell. I actually spent 5 years teaching school and doing public relations work for school, and I had great mentors there, but people who had influenced my life. in addition to my family. But, you know, I like to say, you know, we're blessed, but we're standing on the shoulders of others. You know, we're standing on the shoulders of our own parents. We're standing on the shoulders of some of the great leaders here, you know, in this community. So I'm grateful for that. I'm grateful for having worked for Shell for almost 25 years. And, you know, my gosh, working with my wife and my son for 15 years in business, I'm blessed. I can't say anything other than
that. That sounds like that's living the dream. The thought of my wife wanting to work with me for 15 years, I've been like, you guys have figured something out. That's magic right there. So real quick, my gratitude goes to my co-host, Clint Akin. He's not here today. He's normally on our show, but Clint has been a friend of mine now for a little over a year. I'm very humble and grateful to have him. He is a servant heart and a wonderful human being. Matter of fact, I got a text with a prayer from Clint this morning, and I usually get one of those every couple of weeks. And so we're kind of allies and support and lift each other up on a consistent basis. And I'm thankful for his efforts to help us support this organization and things that he's doing. So we missed him this week. He's out enjoying some family time. And as we wrap up again, I want to acknowledge our sponsors.
I was going to say, isn't that his role? He jumps in here and says,
he is.
Industrial Safety Training Council, McDonough Engineering Corporation, and Turner.
There you go.
Great members of this organization, great sponsors of the podcast.
Wonderful. We thank you very much. Thanks for tuning in to episode 3. Again, make sure you tune in next week for episode 4. We're going to have Miss Carla Thompson from one of our sponsors, Turner Industries.
Turner Industries, and she's also an expert in the workforce development
area. Yeah, we can't wait to hear about that. And stay tuned on LinkedIn, Facebook, YouTube, and all your local podcast channels as this show will be distributed next week, and you guys can tune in and hear or catch the show. So we look forward to it, and have a good day.
Thank you.
Economic Alliance thanks you for tuning in to the Gulf Coast Growth Show. Be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel and share with your friends.